G'day, Jacob from Make Science Fun. Thanks for tuning in today. Now, you've got a science fair project, or you've got a science research project, or you've got some exciting science experiment that you've got to do, and you don't know what project to choose. Well, I'm here to help you. I'm a science teacher. I've been teaching for about 15 years or so, and I've marked hundreds of these projects. Now, I can tell you what a teacher's looking for. A teacher is looking for an interesting project with some form of real-life application. So, in this video, I'm going to show you three really good ideas and how to do them. All the best. So the first possible project to choose from is sound insulation of a garage, investigating the best way to insulate your garage for sound. When we put this studio together, we wanted to be able to film at any time of the day without noise affecting us. And so I went to a special effort to make sure that the windows had special foam insulation, and I put curtains up around the room to absorb the sound. And that also means that I can make noise without bothering anyone else.
Keep it down, darling.
Bothering anyone else. So your project is to pretend that you are starting up a garage band, and this is a model of the garage. Let's say you want to make a lot of noise in your garage and maybe play your favourite song.
Trying to see what I can do to test the science and break through. No right, no wrong, new rules for me. I can do my SRP, SRP.
Now let's say you're making some awesome music like that, but your family doesn't want to hear you. So in this project, you have to investigate different ways to sound insulate your garage. So you might try things like you have your speaker making the noise, and on the outside, to measure the sound, you can have a sound app on, and you probably want to measure the sound without any insulation to be your control for the experiment. And then you want to insulate your room, and so you might try carpet and find the sound. You might try aluminium foil. You might try special foam. You might try curtain material. You might try cardboard. So you can try a whole lot of different sound insulations and determine which one is the most effective. You can look at the cost. You can look at the ease of use. You can look at the environmental effectiveness. So it's a useful, interesting project. That's project number one.
G'day, back up to Make Science Fun here. Checking out this snowboard ramp in the ice. I'm pretty interested in it because of the ice and the sulfate of ammonia that they put on the ice. I'm interested to see why they put sulfate of ammonia on it. I mean, what does it do? Does it make the ice more slippery or what? Does it make it last longer? I don't know why they're putting it on. Here we go. Woo!
Yeah,
that's not a bad grind.
All right. Oh, g'day, Sam. How are you? I'm fine. On that footage of the snow... Oh, no, what have you done? Let's fix it. Yeah. On that footage of the snowboarding, did you notice that what they did was they got ice. So they got ice.
Oh.
Do you want to help me out, Sam? That's it. Let's put the ice onto the ramp. And what they did was they added salt. And sulfate of ammonia to the ice. And my question is, why? Why did they add salt and sulfate of ammonia?
It's cold.
It's freezing, all right. And so the experiment would be, or the research project would be to find the answer to why they actually add the salt and the sulfate of ammonia. So you'd start with just plain ice, and you'd have some form of mock-up wakeboard. And you'd slide it down the ramp. You'd probably do a longer one. Yeah, that one's not very good. Try this one, Sam.
That'd be.
Okay. Woo! And you time how long it takes to slide down. And you do it quite a few times so that you can get an average. And you'd also time how long it took for the ice to melt.
A little bit of more ice.
Let's put a bit more. Let's pack it out a bit. Is it nice?
My hand is starting to get cold.
Yeah. So once you did it without salt and without sulfate of ammonia, then you'd actually put some new ice on and you'd put some salt and you'd see how long it lasts and what it does to the slipperiness. You put some sulfate of ammonia on and see what it does to the slipperiness. So basically, the science research project would be to investigate how effective it is to use salt and sulfate of ammonia on an ice ramp. Now that's a pretty interesting project, isn't it, Sam? Is that interesting? Yeah.
Ooh. Or I can put some of this in.
Okay.
Oh.
Oh, you got some ice there. Let's give it another go. Ready?
Woo! Oh, yeah!
That was a good one. Did you see that, Sam? Have a look.
Woo! That put ice here and let it melt.
Okay. In your third choice for your science research project, the question that we want you to answer is, what is the best coloured light for plants to grow under? Is it yellow?
Green.
Green.
Red.
Red.
Blue. Purple.
Purple.
Pink.
Pink. Who knows? That's what you need to find out. So you'd need to set up a series of hot houses. You'd have to have a control. That is one where the cellophane has got no colour. And in each hot house, you'd have a number of plants, all the same, all identical across all the experiment. And you'd water each one the same amount, you'd have them in the same location, so that the only variable, the independent variable, is the colour of the cellophane. Now the dependent variable is the one which you'll be measuring every afternoon, and that is the height of the plant. And so you'll actually record the heights of the plants as they grow, and at the end of the couple of weeks of growing, you'll be able to graph and be able to see quite clearly what is the optimum colour for plants to grow under. That sounds like a pretty interesting project, doesn't it, Sam? Hey, would you like to do that? What colour do you think the plants would grow best under?
Blue.
Blue, you think blue? How come?
Because I like blue.
And blue's a bug. Oh! It's wrecked my hothouse. Hopefully you can make a stronger one than I have. That's all from me from Make Science Fun. I look forward to your comments and I look forward to finding out your results of your experiment. Bye for now.
Dad, I break it.
Yeah. Boom. Okay. For a weekly video, please click the Make Science Fun logo below and I'll be seeing you soon.